years of broadcasting.
This is Lowell Thomas in New York. He made it. Charles A. Lindbergh, Lucky Lindy as they call him, landed at Le Bourget Airport, Paris.
But I have found it impossible to carry out responsibility and to discharge my duties as king as I would wish to do. Without the help and support of the woman I love.
Forward! Bring Deutschland! In uns!
It's over. Begin.
The Japanese have attacked Pearl Harbor, Hawaii by air. President Roosevelt has just announced.
We will gain the inevitable triumph. So help us God.
A press association has just announced that President Roosevelt is dead.
Let us pray that peace be now restored to the world.
Over the past centuries, of the millions of creatures that dwell on our planet Earth, man alone has developed the science of technical communication. It is this very aspect that promoted and furthered its progress. Man's knowledge of how to disseminate his ideas, aspirations, and his hostilities make him different than the animal. From the beginning, man attempted to communicate with his friends and enemies, first using the trumpet, then the heliograph, then later the semaphore, the Leyden jar, the electric magnet. Samuel Morse, Cyrus Field, Alexander Bell, James Maxwell invented, developed, and improved their ideas. But it was not until the work of Marconi that the goal of sending the human voice through the air became a reality. It was this knowledge which had already been imparted, and some embellishment by Lee DeForest and David Sarnoff, that from somewhere beyond the ether came forth a medium called radio. Radio would have profound effects on the social and economic life of the world. Thus, it came into being, a wailing young brat demonstrating with Victrola records and election returns. But within one half century, the newborn babe would mature and grow, would captivate the minds and hearts of the multitude, serving as its voice, its brain, its very being. The radio spoke.
We have a press report over the wires. We hope that it is unconfirmed, but we have to doubt it. The President of the United States has been the victim of an assassination.
Yeah, there is Leon. He's been shot. He's been shot. Lee Oswald has been shot. There's the man with a gun. It's absolute panic. Absolute panic here in the basement of Dallas Police Headquarters.
Free at last! Free at last! Thank God Almighty, we are free at last!
Some men see things as they are and say why. I dream things that never were and say why not.
It's one small step for man.
Across every town in America, radio's voice was heard. And it's fairly safe to say that no matter where people lived and worked, they heard the New England twang of Fred Allen, the clipped accents of H.B. Calvinborn, the twitter of Gracie Allen, the thundering hooves of the great horse Hilton, Edward R. Murrow intoning, "This is London." By its very nature, radio was compelled to enlist the very imagination of the listener. And this is why radio has survived. But there is no place in the world today where this quality is maintained, as in the pulsing, vibrant city of Detroit, Michigan.
Woo-hoo!